is all that I can give to you. Love is more than just a game for two. Two in love can't make it. Take my heart, please don't break it. Love was made for me and you, yeah. It's for the way you look at me. Oh, it's for the only one I see. V is lovely, baby, extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore. I can love is all.
Good afternoon, good morning, Westfield. Thank you guys so much for having me. I want to extend a huge thank you to the Westfield Senior Center for sponsoring me for this program this afternoon or this morning, whenever this is airing. My name is Noah Liss. If you're new to the Westfield Senior Center or Westfield in general, maybe you have heard of me, maybe not, but I was a season 6 contestant on NBC's hit television show The Voice, where I was on Team Blake Shelton, and I hail from the small little town, a little east of you guys, called Palmer, Massachusetts. So it's great to be here, great to celebrate the month of February with you all. This month is about love, loving your spouse, are loving your family and loving those around you, and also the love that God has for us in our lives. So we're going to celebrate love here for the next hour or so. And if you know any of the words to these songs, feel free to sing, dance at home if you can. I won't tell Governor Charlie Baker that you're dancing, so. But thank you guys so much again for having me. And this next song I'm going to do is a classic. It's one of my favorite songs to sing, and it's a song called Save the Last Dance for Me. You can dance every dance with the guy who gives you the eye, let him hold you tight. You can smile every smile for the man who held your hand beneath the pale moonlight. But don't forget who's taking you home, and then whose arms you're gonna be. So don't say the last dance for me. Oh, I know that the music's fine, like sparkling wine, go and have your fun. Laugh and sing, but while we will part, don't give your heart to anyone. But don't forget who's taking you home, and in his arms you're gonna be. So don't you know I love you so? Can't you feel it when we touch? I will never, never let you go. Oh, I love you oh so much. You can dance, go and carry on till the night is gone and it's time to go. If he asks, if you are alone, can he walk you home? You must tell him no. But don't forget who's taking you home. He knows how you're gonna be. So darling, take the last dance for me. That the music's fine, like sparkling wine, go and have it fine. Laugh and sing, but while we were apart, don't give your heart to anyone. But don't forget who's taking you home, and there's something for me. So stop and save my so much. It's great to welcome you guys. This is my shop, by the way, my little humble abode in downtown Three Rivers, and that's where I do all my operations from. And during the pandemic, it's been great. I can live stream video from here, so don't mind my half black wall back there. We're in the middle of a construction zone right now, so it's great to still be able to do some work out of here. But this next song I'm going to do is my favorite song. It's got to be one of my favorite love songs, and it's by a guy named Engelbert Humperdinck, and you guys might have remembered him, but he had this beautiful song, and if you know the words, feel free to sing it with me. This is a song called After the Lovin'. So I sing you to sleep after the lovin' with a song I just wrote yesterday. And I hope you can hear what the words and the music have to say. It's so hard to explain everything that I'm feeling. Face to face, I just seem to go dry. And the sound of your voice, it's so weird that it makes me want to cry. Thanks for taking me on a one-way trip to the sun. And thanks for turning me into one. So I sing you to sleep after the loving. I brush back
so real that it makes me wanna cry. And I know that my song isn't saying anything new. Oh.
You guys should remember this one. It's a classic.
While the summer wind came blowing in from across the sea, it lingered there to touch your hair and warm me. All summer long, we sing that song. And we stroll the golden sand, two sweethearts and that summer wind. Like painted kites, those days and nights, they went flying by. Well, the world was new beneath the blue umbrella sky. While in something in the problem. Still those days, those lonely days, they go on and on.
Thank you.
So you guys should know the words to this.
Take my whole life too, for I every song, and I sing along. Cause you're my everything.
One of my favorite artists growing up was a guy named Billy Joel, and some of you might know him. You know, I have an affection for those singer-songwriters, especially the piano players, you know. So we're going to do a Billy Joel song, then we'll do a little Elton. This is one of my favorite Billy Joel songs. It's a beautiful love song, and if you've ever heard it, it's called She's Always a Woman to Me. She can kill with a smile, she can wound with her eyes, and she can ruin your faith with her casual lies. And she only reveals what she wants you to see. She hides like a child, but she's always a woman to me. She can lead you to love, she can take you on. She can ask for the truth, but she'll never believe you. And she'll take what you give her as long as it's free. She steals like a thief, but she's always a woman to me. Ahead of her time, and oh, and she never gives out, and she never gives in. She just changes her mind, and she'll promise you more than the Garden of Eden. Then she'll carelessly cut you and laugh while you're bleeding. But she'll bring out the best and the worst you can't be. Blame it all on yourself, cause she's always a woman to me. She is frequently kind and then softly cruel. She can do as she pleases, she's nobody's fool. And she can't be convicted, she's earned a degree. And the most she will do is throw shadows at you, but she's always a woman. Now that we did a little Billy, we got to do Elton, and he's one of my favorites as well. Actually, my first real concert I ever went to. My first real concert was Raffi when I was about 3 years old. But Elton was my first concert for real. So this is one of my favorite songs. You know, this year has been a tough year for musicians around the world, and the music industry is really taking a hard hit by this pandemic. And you guys have shown at home, and my fan base has stayed alive and has really helped me get through this difficult time. And I just am so appreciative for all the support and all of the prayers and everything of getting through this pandemic and having a career when all said and done. So thank you guys so much for your undying support. And I want to do this song because this is one of my favorite songs to do. And it's a song that about, you know, the fans. And if you're a loyal fan, I appreciate you and I love you and thank you so much. So this is your song. It's a little bit funny, this feeling inside. I'm not one of those who can, he's only high. I don't have much money, but boy, if I did, I'd buy a big house where we both could live. If I was a sculptor, but then again, no, a man who makes potions in a traveling show. No, it's not much, but it's the best I can do. My gift is my song, and this one's for you. Can tell everybody this is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's done, oh, hope you don't mind, oh, hope you don't mind that I put down in words how wonderful life is while you're in. I sat on the roof and I kicked off the you guys. They call you Lady Luck, but there is room for doubt. At times you have a very unladylike way of running now. Your honest statement, the pickings have been lush. And yeah, before this evening is over, you might give me the brush. You might forget your manners. You might refuse to stay. And so the best that I can do is pray. Doesn't leave her escort. This year has been a very difficult year for many, many families, and it's been a difficult month for me and my family the last month. We all ended up getting COVID-19 in my house, and we unfortunately lost my grandmother about 2 weeks ago from the virus and complications from the virus. And it's been a really trying time for us, a really trying time for my family. And I know that we're not alone, that there are many other families out there that are experiencing the same heartbreak and loss. And, you know, we were so fortunate enough to be able to hold her hand through it and see her in the hospital, in the ICU. So I'm very fortunate for that and thankful to God for opening those doors to make that happen. And I want to share a song with you all. This is one of my songs that I wrote. And this is a song that I actually wrote about my grandparents and about my grandmother who just passed away. And it's a beautiful love song. I think it's one of the most beautiful love songs in the entire world because it's about my family. And you hear about those fairy tale love stories on the computer and those testimonies for these wonderful kind of magical love stories. But this is my family's magical love story. And it's about my grandfather who was a product of a very bad home environment. And his father ended up giving him and his six brothers and sisters to the state as foster kids. And back then they called them state kids. This was shortly after his mother passed away during a pregnancy. And he said, "I don't want to be your father anymore." And my grandfather spent his entire childhood traveling between these farms and living with these different families. And back then, they were used for slave labor. And there was very poor conditions in the foster care system. And a lot of times, they weren't fed if they didn't get their chores done during the day. And he, for all of the struggles of his upbringing, he was the most amazing grandfather and the most amazing father to my mother and my Uncle Glenn. But he ended up moving down to this farm that was right down the road from my grandmother, where my grandmother lived. And they fell in love. They met in grammar school, fell in love instantly, and it was kind of fate. And I wrote this song after their first date. It kind of inspired me, which was to the prom. And shortly after he graduated from high school, my grandfather went off into the service. He was in the Air Force and sent back a ring to my grandmother and said, "Be wearing this when I return home and marry me." And she put it in her hope chest and was wearing it the day that he returned home. And I will forever hold this song deep in my heart. It's a song that that is part of my identity, and I'm just so grateful that I got the chance to share it with both of them before they passed. So this is, this is one of my my original songs. It's called "Come Dance With Me." Just a bad boy from the wrong side of town. Nothing to call his own. Worn out clothes and hand-me-downs. She was just a good girl from the farm down the road. Hard-working family and a love that overflowed. He called. And the kid that no one wants. I got time for a couple more songs here. Now, when we're talking about love, now love is, knows no bounds. When you love someone, you go to the ends of the earth for them. And when Jesus loves you, which he loves all of us, he'll go to the ends of the earth for us. And I always like to do one song at least. We're going to do a couple songs here, but at least one song to worship the King of Kings, because when there's no one else to turn to, And when you feel like you're alone, you can always turn to the one, the only, Jesus Christ. And he knows what you need before you even can think of it. And he's our wonderful counselor, and he goes before us. And I've been had so much faith that we're going to get through this pandemic. And despite all of the setbacks, he's opened up so many wonderful doors for me and my family during this time. So I want to share this song with you guys. It's one of my favorite songs to sing. And it's a worship song. It's a song we do at my church. And it's a beautiful song. It's called Where You Are. So hope you enjoy.
Jesus, there is nothing like your love. As long as life endures, my chains are gone. I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me.
So much. I got time for one more song. I want to thank you again. Thank you, the Westfield Senior Center, for sponsoring me for this hour program. Thank you to Pete and Jay over at the public access station. Your work and commitment does not go unnoticed. I see all your posts on Facebook and everything about all the stuff you guys are doing. So thank you so much for your devotion to the local access program there in Westfield. Thank you, guys. Thank you for watching. God bless. Stay healthy. And I'll be praying for you all and keep you all in my prayers for good health and success in the coming year. So we're going to end with this song. Thank you, guys. God bless. Take care. And stay healthy.
Tell me, when will you be mine? Tell me cuando. We can share another divine. Please don't.